Last weekend, we were driving south through the high Nevada desert, and unfortunately, a car traveling just in front of us hit an elk. Aside from a few minor cuts from the windshield exploding, the driver was unharmed.
Whoa, my seatbelt saved my life!
The elk was dead, and the front end of the car was crushed and burning. The impact had started a fire. A car on fire is a dangerous thing. According to FEMA, car fires kill 300 people and injure 1,000 more each year. You see, a car is not just a metal box on wheels with a gasoline tank. In addition to the steel or aluminum frame of the car, there are polyesters, carbon fibers, thermoplastic olefins, polycarbonates, polyamides, polyurethane foam, PVC glass, and cloth or leather in the car. Chemically speaking, a car is actually a metal box full of combustibles. The average car has several hundred pounds of plastics, and that plastic contains a lot of reduced carbon. And carbon likes to be oxidized.
Oxidation agrees with me.
I wish we could be CO2.
I can get you there.
Sweet!
After learning that the driver was unharmed, we all moved back and watched the fire grow. There were several loud explosions, probably from the tires, battery, airbags, and radiator blowing up. Emergency responders were on their way, but we were in a remote location that was about 35 minutes drive from the nearest town. And let me tell you, a half hour feels like a really long time when you're waiting for a fire truck. The sagebrush next to the car caught fire, and I started getting worried. I worked for several years as a wildland firefighter, and I could tell that by the time the fire truck arrived, there would probably be a forest fire blazing that would be too big for it to handle. But fortunately, a couple of the people who stopped by the side of the road with us were local. They made phone calls, and within just a few minutes, two pickup trucks pulled up and a handful of people jumped out with shovels and handheld fire extinguishers. We happened to have a shovel in our car as well, so I joined the group and we all dug line together, clearing out the brush and creating a semicircle of bare earth around the fire. By the time the fire truck arrived, we'd contained the brush fire. It took two hoses several minutes to get the blaze in the car under control, which gives you some appreciation for just how hot a car fire is. Water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit, and bread bakes at about 350 degrees. A vehicle fire can get as hot as 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. Considering how many cars are on the road, vehicle fires are pretty rare, but when they do happen, they get hot so fast and the shrapnel from things exploding and the toxic gases produces can be deadly. So if your car engine ever looks like it's about to start on fire, you want to evacuate the vehicle as soon as you possibly can. Hitting wildlife, unfortunately, is a much more common occurrence. Each year, over a million cars collide with deer or elk. It's a sad fact. Sometimes there's nothing you can do to avoid a collision. The deer might jump onto the road in front of you and you don't even have time to blink before the crash. Living in Hawaii reduces your chances of hitting a deer by a lot, but there are other things you can do to lower the risk that don't involve moving to a tropical island. If you're driving at dawn or dusk, slow down. You can see deer any time of day or night, but they're most active at dawn and dusk. Use bright lights or your high beams when you drive in the dark. A few seconds warning can make a big difference. If you see one animal, slow down because they often travel in groups. And be vigilant. Don't just look at the yellow line when you drive, be looking at the sides of the road and be alert for any movement or sign of wildlife. Thanks for watching this Science Mom video. Remember to travel safe and to take care of your fellow human beings. Acts of kindness can be as big as fighting a fire together or as simple as picking up a radiator cap.
Lovers. Oh.
Put that on your mantle so you can always remember.
Radiator blue there.